Today's video, it's what they call a spicy meatball. This is going to annoy some people. Totally get it. I do just want to say that I don't really have a horse in this race, and I'll definitely explain my thoughts on it. But there was a question brought up in a recent video by a friend of mine, Slcmof. He also covers a lot of DC stuff. He's definitely, he takes care of Batman even more than I do. You know, I cover Batman, but I also try to do like 50 other things, and it's just one focus for me. Slcmof definitely goes in on Batman. He covers it very well. And I do want to address this question. And that question is, would you buy an Xbox or an Xbox Series console to play Batman? It's a question that I find very interesting because it's one that he brings up in one of his newer videos, which I definitely will link below, where he covers very well the whole situation and the hypotheticals going on with WB Games possibly being acquired by Microsoft. Now, when I brought up this point a little bit too in my video as well, talking about, hey, is Batman going to become an Xbox game? I noticed a lot of pushback from people. It seemed like people were very annoyed by this very quickly. And I do have some questions about that and also some thoughts as well. So my first question is, would you buy an Xbox One Series X or Xbox Series X in order to play Batman or to play Middle Earth or to play any of these games if they went exclusive? Or maybe you're somebody else who has a PC. I don't know, maybe you would play it there because those Xbox exclusives usually end up coming to PC at one point or another or being accessible through the Xbox store on PC. That's, I think, an interesting question that is worth answering. I know that for me personally, I definitely think I would end up buying an Xbox Series X to play this game. Now, I'm somebody who from the last generation, I technically have all three machines. I have a Switch, a PlayStation 4, and an Xbox One X. I did not get these all at launch. I'm not Mr. Moneybags. I bought them actually over years, and I didn't even get a PlayStation 4 until almost a year after it launched, with the Xbox One being a few years after that. It crapped out, and I ended up getting a One X and my Switch about 2 weeks ago. So for me, the platform has never mattered. I'm not somebody who's like, you know, really given the reach around to Sony or Microsoft or anybody like that. I don't care. I've talked about the console wars and just not giving a crap about it before. I care where fun games are. And I also have mixed feelings on exclusives, though, at the same time. Now, there are games that I am totally fine with it for. Now, for example, when I talk about this, I think that one of my friends put it perfectly when I was talking to him today, and his thoughts on exclusives pretty much match mine, and that is that games that wouldn't otherwise exist without the backing of that company, I'm totally fine with those being an exclusive. So a good example of that is a game that just came out that a lot of people are not going to know what it is, Deadly Premonition 2. This game would not be made if Nintendo hadn't helped foot the bill for it. Why? Because the original game is a cult classic, and when you say cult classic, that means a bunch of people love it, but 99% of people don't know what it is or don't care. It sucks. The first game's a really fun game. I really enjoy it, but it didn't have strong sales. It just didn't. And so it kind of comes down to this sense of, well, we're not going to see another one unless somebody steps in and foots the bill. That's where Nintendo came in, and it is now on the Switch, along with a ported version of the original game. They helped back that. You know, there's other things too, like Bayonetta 2. That's a game that we wouldn't have technically probably seen without the Wii U, as sad as it is to say that. Games like this, I am definitely fine with being exclusives. I think that those are really fun linchpins of a console library. I think that they make it so that each thing has its own flavor to it. And also, it makes it so that a big burden of the cost and the risk is on Sony or on Microsoft or on Nintendo. That's where I think exclusives should generally be. Where it gets murkier for me is stuff like Marvel's Spider-Man. Did I have a PlayStation 4? Yep. So because I had these systems, it doesn't really bother me as much for my own sake that they're split among them because I don't care about the platform. I just care about the games. And hypothetically, having different exclusives on different platforms should mean that each one is striving to make better exclusives to actually compete with the other ones. But then this last generation, we did see a bunch of exclusives from Sony and not nearly as many from Xbox. So that's not always true either. Xbox focused more on backwards compatibility and trying to be an accessible platform for people, even going in on the gamer accessibility for people who have physical disabilities with their own Xbox controller for the disabled, stuff like that. I mean, these were the directions Xbox was going and experimenting in. They weren't necessarily pushing as much into trying to be a big console exclusive library. Meanwhile, Sony comes out of the bat, whether you hate or love Sony, I'm just saying these are facts you can't deny. They come just right out swinging with Infamous right at the beginning, Killzone Shadowfall. They definitely work their way up, and they have things like God of War, they have Bloodborne, they have Marvel's Spider-Man. I mean, there is a lot on that console that you can't play elsewhere. Even Horizon Zero Dawn, which is now finally coming to PC, but my point is a lot of that console library still not available on PC or anywhere else. But I don't notice as many people complain about it there, and I do wonder if that's because it's the system that won this generation. I mean, it's the more popular, it sold more units. I don't really know why that is. I also did notice for sure that it kind of reminded me, like, what I said in that video and the response to it, not to me personally, because it doesn't offend me at all. It reminded me a little bit of how I felt when I was younger, where it would be like I would buy a machine, like I would buy the PlayStation 2, and it's like, oh man, Sony's so cool. I don't really feel that way anymore. Now I just buy something, and it's like, if it's a good system, it's a good system. If it's not, it's not. That's it, the end. I don't really care about the company that much. I don't have brand loyalty, really. But I did kind of notice that sense of brand loyalty in terms of, hey, how can they take Batman away from me? It's interesting, though, because I don't think this is a feeling that Sony players have had in a long time. I mean, when's the last time, if you're a PlayStation player who doesn't have an Xbox, when is the last time that there was a game other than this taken to one platform that wasn't Sony PlayStation? You know, I mean, there are examples, but are there ones that you really care about? Do you really care much about ReCore? Do you really care much about Sunset Overdrive? No offense, Sunset Overdrive, you're a great game. Do you really care too much about Halo? I mean, if you grew up playing Sony, you probably don't. Gears, same thing. So I think that this is definitely a feeling that a lot of Sony players haven't felt in a long time. And I know that if I only had a PlayStation, it would probably bother me more than it does as well. It is something that's frustrating because it locks down the accessibility of these games to just one group of people. But I guess my question is a little bit, when is that okay and when is it not? You know, when are you okay with console games being exclusive to one console? And do you want timed exclusives or do you want them to be exclusive? And I guess my other question that I do want to ask is, would you buy the Xbox Series X to play Batman? Now, I've rambled a little bit during this video because it was off script and it was just my thoughts, just trying to get them out there. I do want to point out a couple more things, though, that I think will ease your mind. If you're somebody who really is against buying the Series X, you're like, no, I just wish I'd have access to this. There is no deal that is finalized between Microsoft and WB Games right now. A lot of this is speculative. A lot of people in the industry have said that WB Games, or that Microsoft is interested in WB Games, in purchasing them and acquiring these games. But there is a lot of unknowns. Would Microsoft necessarily make every single game under WB Games console exclusive? No, I don't think they would. I do think that Batman would go that way to compete with Spider-Man. But I don't think that they would do that with, say, the Lego games. It makes no sense. You're shooting yourself in the foot. And like Slcmof pointed out, it is kind of like Minecraft. You wouldn't take Minecraft and just make it on one platform so only a certain amount of people could access it when it is such a widespread phenomenon among people of every age. Even Batman compared to that is a more niche thing, but it's also a AAA big budget experience that targets a huge swath of people and gets a lot of money. And it would get a ton of people, even if not you, and maybe let's just say hypothetically not me, it would move a ton of Xbox units and get a ton of people to buy one. Because not everybody can afford a PC. When I built my PC, there's going to be a PC person in the comments who's going to say, wow, you paid a lot for that. Totally get it. That's valid. When I built my PC, if you include the dual monitors and the accessories, it was about $3,000. That was money I saved up from years of work. Like, it was excess money that I didn't spend on other things that I put back into the channel for a business investment and for my own personal enjoyment. Not everybody can do that. I'm 25 years old. I could not have afforded a PC platform until I was 25. Because of that, it sort of comes down to this place where really Xbox Series X is going to be the place where people go for Batman, a lot of gamers, if it's on Xbox and PC. But at the same time, there is no deal finalized. I think that's definitely worth pointing out multiple times because people get really jumpy about this. We don't have all the facts on this. They might not necessarily make something exclusive to one platform. And also, just because they might strike a deal doesn't mean it will affect this Batman game that we pretty much know is in development. Why do I say that? They were already teasing this thing. There were lots of reports that this was going to have been revealed already, if not for COVID. So that was pretty much not guaranteed, but very likely that this is something we would know more about if not for the virus. And also, they wouldn't start marketing this game now, be acquired by Microsoft in, let's say, earliest, in 3 to 6 months from now. The game comes out in, say, a year. I'm just throwing you hypothetical timelines. And 6 months ahead of time, they decide, nah, JK, that's not going to PlayStation. They would be so far in development for this already that this game would most likely go to everything. No matter what, because trust me, if they're making a Batman game like we've seen the symbols, like we've seen everybody talk about, like we just saw Ed Boon hint about, who has worked very closely with WB Games, the thing is they are so far in development to be teasing this and doing this other stuff with it, and from all the reports, that they wouldn't be just saying, nah, JK, it's not on PlayStation now. That port is mostly finished. I can guarantee that to you, that if they are making a Batman game, which I am 99.9999999% sure they are from my own sources, from things that I have read, from things that I have watched, from things like Ed Boon and Scott Snyder, if they are doing that and they're this far in development, it is not something that you just cut a port for a few months or 6 months before release. That would be stupid. That would have wasted millions of dollars and it would make no sense. So I don't really think that you need to worry about this Batman game, this one, being only on the Xbox Series X and the PC. Now, do I know that 100% for certain? No. But I do want to point that out because I think it's something a lot of people have not really been thinking about. I think that this business deal applies to future games. If WB Games is bought by Microsoft, this is going to apply heavily going forward. I believe post this game, and possibly even post the next DC game that they're heavily in development for. But it could actually drop in the middle where it affects the next one. I don't know. I do think that that's worth pointing out, though, and I would love to hear your thoughts on this. Would you buy an Xbox Series X to play Batman? If you're okay with Spider-Man being an exclusive and not okay with Batman, why is that? Or do you think that neither of them should have been? I'm interested in that as well. And when are you okay with something being an exclusive? What are your thoughts on it? Do you like the competition that it pushes? Do you like the idea of it pushing other companies to make better games? Or do you feel like it's just an artificial thing that cuts off access to games? I think that's definitely a conversation worth having and maybe a future video topic in and of itself. Let me know what you think in the comments down below because I am actually very interested in this one to get your feedback on what you heard me say or what you're thinking about it. Be sure to check out the links down there. We've got the new Let's Play channel, as always, where we're hanging out, playing some fun games. Twitter, Instagram, Reddit, Patreon, Discord, they are all down there. And I'll see you in the next one, guys. Have a fantastic day, and I hope you all stay shway.